July is just right around the corner, and why not get your kids involved in celebrating and helping you decorate? Joe Kraus, author of Baby Raby, is that right? Baby Raby's blog. And very soon, mom-to-be. Oh, so cute. She joins us with some great crafty ideas. Okay, we were talking in the break, and I was saying I have such fond memories of doing 4th of July arts and crafts with my mom, because I think it's, everyone probably has a lot of this stuff lying around, and they don't even know it.
Yeah, I mean, especially us, like, we have like a million empty toilet paper rolls. Just, I don't know why we keep them, but there's
red, white, and blue paint.
Exactly.
I mean, if you have kids, you probably have that. You probably have sponges. So these are some fun things to do with the kiddos. Keep them entertained, because they're probably getting a little stir crazy.
Exactly.
And then they can help in the process, and that makes them feel involved.
And it kind of makes you feel like one of those cool, crafty moms, but I promise these are super easy things to do.
Yes.
It's not going to be a lot of work.
You can impress your friends and be the cool, crafty mom at the same
time.
Yeah, I love this.
They'll be totally impressed. They'll think you spent all this time on Pinterest, and it's a really easy thing.
Don't you love that when you think you've almost fooled your friends? Like, did you get that on Pinterest? No, I did it myself.
I just did it myself.
Okay, let's talk about these cute t-shirts.
Yeah. So these I made for my son and my daughter. And I love that they have like a little bit of a vintage feel to these flags. And
they're
it was super easy to make. So basically you just want to get some sponges.
Okay.
And
you can get those for like three for a dollar at Walmart.
At the dollar store, wherever. And you want to draw your flag. So you want to make sure that you draw the flag backwards, though, because
otherwise you're gonna have, once you put it on, you're gonna have a backwards flag
on your shirt. And you know, it doesn't have to be like exactly, you know, the number of stripes, and this is an artistic interpretation, right?
Okay.
So once you have your flag drawn out, you just take your red, white, and blue fabric paint, and you're gonna paint your sponge.
Okay.
And you don't want to saturate it too much.
And this looks, I mean, this shirt, you would look at that and think that that looks really hard, but y'all, this is actually, I think I could do this.
It's so easy. It took me, I mean, I just did this on the break. It takes me like 2 minutes to paint
so
this up.
Okay, so then we just,
and then you just lay it over your shirt. So what's,
are you going to let me do this?
Go for it. Yeah, you got it. And what's great is about having the kids
do
this. Yeah, push it down. Make sure you push it really good on all four sides and in the center.
I'm crafty. DIY.
But you know, even the old, like my five-year-old son, I could say, okay, you paint red, white, and then he's got it. You know, it's all him.
So mine's not as...
But it's still like...
But it still is kind of cool.
Yeah, I think it looks a little vintage.
I do too.
I like that.
I am so crafty.
To do the stars, I just did... So there's a couple different ways you could do this.
Okay.
I just did last night, because my kids were in bed, the back of the paintbrush.
And then you just kind of like dotted it on.
And then just added the stars. But you know what else you could do with your kids is you could have them use their pinky finger to do little fingerprints. Depending on how much you trust them with paint on their hands.
Okay, so a project that looks really difficult, but it's fun. Kids
Super
are involved.
Easy.
They're going to get to paint. That's awesome.
Super easy.
Now, these little ideas I thought were so cute. These are homemade firecrackers.
Yeah.
Moms, don't worry. Not those kind of firecrackers.
No, they're not explosive, and you can put anything inside. So we were saying, like, you could even make this for, like, adults and put, like, a bottle of, like...
A mini bottle of tequila
inside.
Like, so you basically just take your used toilet paper roll.
And one key thing that you want to do beforehand is you just cut... it almost in half, but you leave a little bit so that it's easy to crack open once it's wrapped.
Oh, okay, so we can go boop.
Yeah,
okay,
and then everything supposedly is supposed to come out. So then you just take, what I did, I mean, you can wrap it however you want. I just did like one red, one white, one blue.
And I have so much tissue paper from like presents.
Exactly.
From like when I give presents to my friends, like lying around my house, this is a great thing to do with it.
Yeah, so.
And you could also even decorate it with your paint if you wanted to make a whole other project.
And I mean, parents, we typically have, I don't even know how many different kinds of stickers laying around.
Yeah.
So it's a great opportunity to use up all that. So you just put your thing in and you would roll it up like so.
And I feel like right now at all, like even like the Walgreens and Target, I'm seeing like the little corner aisles that have like tons of patriotic ribbon or stickers or bows or tape. And so they go on sale, I feel like the day before 4th of July.
Exactly.
So you could stock up on all those and then have a little fun project.
And I got all these at the craft store yesterday, and they have a great selection right now. So I just have a fun little red and blue washi tape.
This is so easy, y'all. Do y'all see
this? Just tie one end with your ribbon. I have some confetti here that you can fill it with.
And so then we can take the end and we just put our little bow and fill it with candy, fill it with lollipops.
With whatever.
Oh, I didn't do that right.
Now, you know what I think I have it.
I need a little bit more mom craft project time practice.
But yeah, and then I picked up some Pop Rocks, some glow sticks,
bubbles. Oh, yeah, so fun.
Yeah, and then I let the kids help me kind of decorate with stickers.
So. And then they can pass these out to their friends, like if you go to Kaboom Town or if you go to the, you know, any of the fireworks with your family. That's such a cute
idea. Yeah, so in theory, I was going to see if I could do this on air. I don't know. I think, there we go.
And then it pops open. And so then you've got all your goodies inside.
Yeah, you've got your confetti.
Happy 4th of July! Okay, these are such fun ideas, Jill. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Okay, you can get more great ideas from Jill by going to her blog. You can get to her blog by going to dthebroadcast.tv and click on today's links.